and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to the Robin Hood here at Briley Hill, where most of the Black Country Night Out, the original Black Country Night Out show, comes from. We thought it was about time we get all the old folks out there who supported we all over these years our own Christmas message. Our own mate John Raven, he's wrote a song specially for Christmas. And we'd like to send our own Christmas greetings to you from Harry Addison, from Dolly Allen, from John Raven, from Brian Clift, and from Tommy Munden, from Ray Inslee, from our guests Keith and Carolyn, and from our lovely audience tonight, the Aston and Erdington Photographic Society. Yeah! And the Buccaneers Variety Artists. Yeah! And where's your Buccaneers? Our Christmas message to you folks, as you slide down the banisters of life, we hope that the splinters am all facing downhill.
Well, we're in here again with a black country cheer to toast all our friends as Christmas draws near. Fill it up and without any further parade, drink to the folk who are black country made.
Strong in the arms, strong in the head, black country born and black country bred. Strong in the arms, strong in the head, black country born and black country bred.
Well, throughout the world, wherever you go, black country folk will soon let you know. If you're friendly and true, you're welcome to stay, to sup and to drink upon Christmas Day.
Strong in the heart, strong in the head, black country born and black country bred. Strong in the heart, strong in the head, black country born and black country bred.
So from Dolly and Brian and Daddy and Ray, a greeting on this Christmas Day. From John and young Tommy, this message we give. Good black country cheer and long may you live.
Strong in the arms, strong in the head, black country born and black country bred. Strong in the arms, strong in the head, black country born and black country bred.
Well, we're here again with a black country cheer to toast all our friends in a bumper of beer. Fill it up and without any further parade, drink to the pub of our black country made.
Strong in the arms, strong in the head,
Just to conclude this off, ladies and gentlemen, I've had a few letters through the post and a couple of phone calls through press offices to do one that I recorded for BBC Two last year. And if I can very quickly explain where I come to write that one, funnily enough, in recent weeks it's been a bit history repeated itself with the power cuts. I called it Reflections in Candlelight, and it's in the brochure that you'll be able to get at half time if you're interested. And it's as well to know where people get inspired to write various stuff, and it was at the Institute for the Blind at Sedgley about 9 years ago. Strangely enough, I've done a concert just this afternoon for members of Tipton and Wheel, who've done a concert for the local blind, and a lot of the people who were in the room at Sedgley were there this afternoon at this church. At that time, ladies and gentlemen, everyone was reduced to candles, I'm sure you will recall it. And everybody was moaning because they couldn't switch the television on. because you couldn't use your electric washers, irons and so forth, you know, and we were all a little bit on edge. And when I went to this place, a 400, 500 audience, everybody, like everybody else, of course, was in the light of candles. But a little bit different to us mortal people who've got everything. These, a lot of these blind people had never even seen the light of a candle. And if there's anybody in this room tonight who's ever thinks you're hard done to, under stress and strain, and we all do, just get a candle and light it in the dark. And if you can see it, go down on your knees. And you'll thank God, because a simple candle in a room can show you up. Life ail gloom. Even when we're in a plight still out of darkness, comes the light, which causes reflections, perhaps more clear. We don't miss nothing till it ain't there. We've been living in enlightened days. We're money-grabbing. It set folks ablaze. And the daily cry for bigger wages, it's plunged me back to darker ages, plain as a pikestaff, in black and white. It's time we all see that light. Let's consider a bit without the jokes. Think of the blind, the afflicted folks, the people in bed, and the people in pain, and the old folks whose path they hardly again are. It's time we all went to school to learn about the golden rule. Could the doctors really strike with all the nurses? In the midst of coping with hospital cases, could housewives and pensioners all join a strike just because they ain't got what they'd like? No. It's the putting in, not the taking out, what lightens life's load without a doubt. I think we should all have misgiving when we count the cost of living. So in our darkest hours, let's smile and bear it, because a load, it's spread if you'll only share it. And you'll really get your values right if you'll just reflect in candlelight. Have you ever stopped and thought a while? You've got untold wealth just to see a smile. The blessings what you've got, if you can only see, you'll never ever buy them off the MEB. And the gifts what you've got to see that light, they'll see you through the darkest night. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.